Well, he is the man with the whiplash smile, the English rock star who came out of the London punk scene with his band Generation X before moving to the States in the early 80s, where he produced a string of smash hit singles and mega-selling albums before imploding in a blaze of sex, drugs and rock and roll. Well, Billy Idol is back. He's in Australia for the first time in 13 years for a sold-out tour with legendary guitarist Steve Stevens, and guess what? He's sounding as good as ever. Billy's not straying too far from his signature sound, his tried and true formula. Remember this?
I stay for a white wedding.
This? And this? Billy Idol owned the 80s.
They must have been pretty wild times in the UK when you were in Generation X and all that stuff.
It was a wild time. I mean, the whole country was in a terrible state. I mean, economically and, well, every way, socially, politically, everything. Punk was the sort of natural thing to come out of that for the youth, I think. It was our only way of speaking, as a lot of the older people were basically telling you there was no future.
Tell me about that time when you went solo, called yourself Billy Idol, you had all those massive hits.
Well, yeah, I mean, that's a lot of it's a blur, of course, you know, like a lot of the touring or... But then there's other moments that are crystal clear and... You know, say writing Rebel Yell, the song, that's crystal clear, you know, or writing Eyes Without a Face with Steve Stevens and rehearsing it and all the, him coming up with that incredible riff in the middle of Eyes Without a Face, you know, it's so exciting. It's a fantastic thing you can get a vibe like that 30 years ago and still be getting that same voodoo off something like that today.
Do you remember the first times, you know, when you put the whiplash smile on and seeing the crowd just go nuts?
It was like that in punk rock really as well, just the way the audiences, their involvement in the music was total, so that it comes out as a physical reaction. And that's what I'm seeing with the Billy Idol solo stuff too. It caused a physical reaction, a kind of people getting so excited.
After a life of sex, drugs and rock and roll, Billy's wake-up call came in 1990 when a serious motorbike accident nearly cost him a leg.
I did listen in the end. I listened to that kind of the voice inside me telling me, you're going too far, you know. There was an element I started to realise, because that motorcycle accident was completely unnecessary. And the fact that I nearly lost my leg over it, that is a bit too... I didn't need that, you know, and I was doing it to myself, so...
I love my body!
The last time Billy was in Australia, he performed at the Rugby League Grand Final. Sort of.
Just waiting for some power!
They kept telling me, it's going to come on, it's going to come on. So I kept waiting, thinking I should have just said, you know what, I don't care if it's coming on. Now, if I'd been more out of it, I would have just started singing the songs.
The live shows, all the hits?
Well, the thing is, yeah, we really do cover the whole of my career, right from some stuff from Generation X or Gen X or and all throughout the Billy Idol solo career. And we're doing things like Can't Break Me Down from today, and it just feels really good fun and exciting.
The legend, Billy Idol's national tour kicked off in Perth. He's playing Wollongong tonight. Dates and details on our website. The album Kings and Queens of the Underground is out now. He's in a good place, isn't he, eh?
Looks good, too. Mm.
Yes, and apparently the show is absolutely fantastic. But wait, we've got more for you today. How would